Good morning students, I hope you all are well at home. Today in this video we are going to start our chapter number 3, that is about of operating system. I hope you all have learned chapter 1 and 2 which I have explained you in my previous videos. Today we are going to start chapter number 3, that is operating system. What is operating system? Operating system is a software which is used to operate any device. Okay, which is used to operate any device, because if I will talk about the computers, computers has many parts: keyboard, mouse, CPU, its memory, its speakers. So one thing which required to control all of them, that is your operating system. So operating system is a software which is used to operate a machine. Your mobile phone has also an operating system. You are watching my videos, you are watching your work, you are doing your work on net, and in your mobile, which operating system is there? Yes, it's Android. It's Android by which you are looking or watching our videos, or you are using internet in Android system. Just like this, computer has also required operating system to operate it. It has many types of operating systems are here. We will discuss in this video. So take out your book and start reading of chapter number 3 with me. I am on page number 39, operating system. You know that computer hardware cannot work without software. You know what is the mean of hardware and software? Hardware are the physical components that can be touched or seen by the user. And softwares are the set of instructions which tells the computer what to perform. So we all know very well, computer is a combination of hardware and software. It is the operating system that tells the hardware what to do and how to do. Clear? So operating system, the main role of operating system to tell the computer what to do and how to do. An operating system, in short you can say OS. So the full form of OS is operating system. It's a type of system software that manages all the computer hardware and software. Operating system is present in almost all computers, or you can say in all electronic devices. It starts working as soon as you turn on your computer. As you turn on your computer, your operating system of computer is started loading. Okay. You can say to run the operating system is called booting. If any error is found in your operating system, your computer will not start. Some examples of operating systems are Microsoft Windows, which we are using generally, Linux, Mac OS, Mac operating system, and DOS, disk operating system. These are some popular operating systems in computer. Why we need operating system, need of operating system? A computer has various parts and they all cannot function properly without software which can control them. Okay? There is a need of some special type of software to manage all the hardwares or softwares of our system. Operating system is the main software that manages all the computer parts and other software. It means the main function of operating system is to manage all the parts, either they are physical or software. It manages all the parts of computer. So that is the main need for operating system. Therefore, operating system is required for every computer to work properly. It also interacts with users, as we cannot communicate directly with the computer hardware. We all cannot directly say to computer or a particular part of computer to do this. We need a mediator between user and computer. That mediator is operating system. So the other task of operating system is, it is a communicate. You can say it's a communicator. Between user and computer. It is a communicator between user and computer. So, functions of operating system. An operating system performs a lot of functions. In a computer, it performs several functions ranging from taking input from the input devices to sending output to output devices. Means functions of operating systems are starting from input and ending on output. You can say some of important functions are, it provides interface to user. It means the same thing, communicator between user and computer. Second point, it manages the different work we give to the computer. Okay, the same. It manages all input, output and storage devices. It manages all the input, output and storage devices. It manages all the files which is stored in the computer. It controls the input and output to the computer. It controls all the external devices which we attached to the computer. For example, I have attached a speaker to my computer. Is speaker work after attaching that speaker work it? No. Speaker will work when installation of software is proper. When the software which is related to a speaker is installed in your computer, that speaker or a hardware will work properly and it will managed by your operating system. It protects the file and applications of computer from damage. So operating systems has an important role to save your file, to manage your file and to protect the file and applications of a software. Now some commonly used operating system we will discuss one by one about of them. First, in your book DOS is there. The full form of DOS is Disk Operating System. It is a CUI. CUI means Character User Interface. It means when I want to talk with the computer, I have to use characters. And to use characters, keyboard is here as an input device. If I want to type anything in computer, because it is a CUI, it can understand only characters from my side, from user side. So you can say DOS is a CUI, character user interface, in which I have to give each and every command by pressing the keys on keyboard. So let's read about DOS. The full form of DOS is Disk Operating System. It is an operating system for single user. It has command line interface, which means you have to type the commands in DOS and interact with the operating system. It is a very simple operating system which occupies very less memory in computer. Nowadays, we use it rarely. We generally use Windows at home or in offices nowadays. Okay, so come on, Microsoft Windows. Windows is a widely used operating system developed by Microsoft for personal computers. It was first made available in 1985. Windows is GUI. Windows, Linux and Mac. These are GUI. It means graphical user interface. It means you have to use in this operating system, we just click by mouse or pointing device on particular diagram or icons and our command will run accordingly. Suppose I want to open a web browser. I will just click on इंटरनेट एक्सप्लोरर और गूगल क्रोम और वट एवर वेब ब्राउजर इज इन योर कंप्यूटर, जस्ट डबल क्लिक ऑन इट एंड आई विल रन इट, वी विल मूव दैट साइट. सो इट इज़ अ जी यू आई. टिल डेट वेरियस वर्जन्स ऑफ विंडोज हैव बीन लॉन्च, द लेटेस्ट वर्जन ऑफ विंडोज इज विंडोज 10. Linux is also a GUI based operating system. It is freely available to anyone. It was first made in 1991. Linux is widely used worldwide for various type of devices. Some of popular Linux distributions are CentOS, Debian, Ubuntu. Ubuntu you are using in mobiles also. So Linux is also GUI. You have to remember that is GUI and launched in 1995. Sorry, and launched in 1991. It's about of Linux. Now Mac operating system. Unix. Mac is not in your book, but it is also same as Linux. One more operating system which is in your book, that is Unix. Unix source code is not available for the general public. Linux is general public source for editing, for you can say it is an open source software. Its source is open for general public, but Unix is not available for the general public. It is primarily uses command line interface. The Unix is written in C, which allows quicker modification, acceptance, and portability. Different versions of Unix are Solaris, AIS, HPUX, BSD, Iris, etc. Unix is an operating system which is popular in companies, universities, and enterprises. Unix is basically CUI. And it is used in companies or big organizations to perform a specific task. Okay, these are about of operating system in your book. So today's homework, you have to read chapter number 3 carefully. Thank you.